get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big low. Yeah. You about to find out what the call. Yeah. I find then I get low. Lift off, it ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop front, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for nothing. Remember we were sliding in that four door Audi when it's
just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. Try and start this drive in the air. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
They'll run for the first time with J.K. Dobbins. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Got an open man, that's David Njoku, the tight end. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
Option play, and they'll hand to Dobbins. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. On play action, they'll throw. This is the tight end, Njoku. And they're going to have another first. As the tackle's made at the Panthers 18. First down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Brian Burns, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for 2nd and 23. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And this is caught. It's Brown. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking themselves and expressing, just keep the hope. We're doing pretty well.
And boy, a good surge defensively. It'll depend on the mark, but I'm not sure he got there. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll look to throw here. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. And the Ravens are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Well, the feel that I get on this is that they felt like 3 was just not going to be enough after getting this deep into their territory.
And Charles, correct me if I'm wrong, but it didn't even look like they hesitated there. They knew they wanted to go for it.
That tells me that during the week, they were thinking about these situations, and they feel like maybe they're just the better team, and they want to go ahead and...
And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line. Hassan Reddick, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. Now back to throw. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Ravens. It's Hollywood Brown. Hollywood Marquise Brown with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Tucker with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
Well, it's been hard over the years. Just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
That's a tough one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Throw left side, McCaffrey's got it. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Play action. Now Kaepernick. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick. He'll let this go for the end zone. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore.
And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet.
How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. James Prochet to return it. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
Here's second and 10. A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Back to throw now on first down. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And they'll use him out in the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. The rookie was trying to push him downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Kaepernick hit, fumble, he lost the football. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. Kaepernick going to throw. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. Touchdown, Carolina! Terrace Marshall, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll set up a throw. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
5 yards remain on second down. They're going to look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
On first down, Dobbins. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They'll drop to throw. Steps away. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And this is caught inside the five. And he takes it all the way down to the three. It's a big play there for Baltimore. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Dobbins. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
Well, every now and then we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your best ability is often your availability. And this is an extremely durable kid coming out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to break big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore, an absolute perfect fit.
And Dobbins, he is not going to get there. They stop him short of the line to gain. Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. Here's Justin Tucker now for the Raven field goal try. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. Tucker's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. They fake the give. Now Kaepernick. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Patrick Queen, he brought the pressure on the blitz, and he gets there for a loss of 12. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. To throw, Kaepernick. He's going to look deep for more. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench into what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
Taking a shot here for Marshall. And that will be incomplete. ball. They weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. There's the Panthers punter now. James Prochet deep for Baltimore. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Prochet on the return. Not a big deal on that one, just your everyday 67-yard punt. And the Ravens will take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Here's a give to Dobbins. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They'll run on first down. Dobbins, and he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 36. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
On first down, Dobbins, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down, a gain of three, second down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Now second and five. Snap will come from the six. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. He'll look to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And with an 8-point lead, probably not too much of an impetus to try and do too much here. That's complete out right to the tight end, Trimble.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. To throw is Kaepernick. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Each team making their final preparations for this second half. We're about ready too, as we'll send you back up to Charlotte and rejoin Brandon and Charles at Bank of America Stadium.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. Taken in at the 3. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Gets it quickly out to Marshall. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
So now at 3rd and 7, and defensively, it's a dime look. 6 DBs. Throwing now is Kaepernick. Eluding the pressure right. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds, well shy of the line of scrimmage, so that's a sack.
Many times when a play breaks down and the quarterback's moving around outside of the pocket, you're thinking, just get rid of something short. But a lot of guys are coached, think deep, take the big shot, hoping someone can get lost behind the secondary. They weren't able to connect on that one.
31 yards on the punt there. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive, as it'll begin in enemy territory already. An option handoff here to Dobbins. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Kamal Martin there on the stop. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. A big loss on the play. That's the bad news. A consolation, they keep the football.
Well, obviously you never want to fumble, but if you do, good to be towards the sideline and saves them the possession.
Saves the embarrassment, saves it going down on the play sheet as a turnover. But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover it. If you give up the football, you gave up the football.
Agree to disagree, I guess.
Can you tell what I played?
Yeah, you played defense. Yeah. I'll let you go.
I took a shot. They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
They certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll take this for about four up to the 46-yard line. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Airing it out deep for Smith. And this throw will be intercepted. Greedy Williams picks it off. And the Ravens are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now.
Right? Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Now it's second and nine. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And that is caught. But he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. They'll look to throw. That's caught. Oh, what a grab by Bateman. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
And time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Second and 10. Now flags come in. I think one of the Ravens got going a little early. that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Back to throw here. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And the Panthers are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game, go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And across midfield, he goes into Raven territory.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
At one. Now Kaepernick. He's going to look deep for more. And that is going to be pulled in. One-handed. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the way? And a big loss here as he's taken down. Brian Burns make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Dobbins running out of the gun. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is taken in by Njoku. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat. And if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
5 yards. Now it's third and five. Stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Open man is Bateman. It's complete. And he will have a Ravens first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on third down and five. They go play action here on first down. Being chased out left. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. They'll find Dobbins out of the backfield. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 26. We have played three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now back to throw. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. He'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll set up to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. David Njoku, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Now there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And that's caught inside the 45. Touchdown, Carolina. Terrace Marshall, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Prochet to return it. And they'll be backed up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Now a throw here to his running back. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be third down. And he's got his man, Marquise Brown. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll look to throw now on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now flags come in. I think one of the Ravens got going a little early. A full start backs him up five, first and 15. Again, he'll drop to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Derrick Brown in there to record another sack, and that is now six on the afternoon for this defensive unit. This one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Back to throw. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
The Ravens on third down. They're at 50%, 4-for-8. This will be third and forever. They'll look to throw here. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
He sets to fire deep, and that is incomplete. The Ravens go for it, but come up empty. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Another run, this time McCaffrey. Space to run past the 20. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that'll increase their lead to 28. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Prochet to return it. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Trying to lay one up deep. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And it would appear that the open week a week ago came just at the right time as they have dominated the proceedings here into this fourth quarter. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Panthers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. And that is incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. It's a 4-yard return following a punt of 49. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
When you run into slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available. And incompletion as a result.
The Ravens on 3rd down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This is 3rd and 10. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Back to throw again. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for them, and after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
They'll look to throw again. And that will be incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And now here's another interception. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
this. Five interceptions. What does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. And whistles, and we're gonna have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Second and goal from the 6 this time. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third and goal from the 6. Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now fourth and goal.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will extend the lead out to 24. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. So now it appears they're going to accept the penalty, which means take away the interception. Also means keep your defense on the field. Don't understand this one one bit. Back to throw now on first down. He's got Njoku over the middle. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
They'll drop to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
Got to be wary of throwing an interception here because the defense knows they're going to get tested deep. That's why they're going to put a couple of extra guys back there to try and prevent that.
Yeah, late in the fourth quarter here, trying to preserve the lead. One final shot. They'll look to throw. This is caught. It's Brown. And a little bit of a consolation prize here. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot.
A lot there. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. At the very end, there's something to take away. They lost the game, but got in the end zone, got a two-point conversion as well. I don't know, though. In the end, you still lost the football game.
You still lost the game, but maybe they were just capitalizing on the flurry at the end, right? You scored the touchdown, keep the momentum.